done over the years. When people, when they have, when the players have gone out there and coaches have done a good job, we love it. We want to see it. And we tell them, yeah, they did a good job. Who did the good job and why they did it. And when they're bad, we tell you why they're bad. What I'm going to tell a quarterback that's making $22.5 million to play 16 weeks and he can't hit a bull in the ass with a banjo? That he's, oh, well, we'll do it next week, or it's this, or we'll do whatever. No. No and no.
But see, you can say no. Everybody can say no, but you got to do something about it. In other words, what are you going to do about it?
Doug, they just gave up 51.
I understand that, Ed.
2 weeks. 2 weeks.
Then they ought to fire all of them.
Green Bay.
Just okay. To go in there and talk to them is not going to do it.
You people have no idea how pathetic this game was tonight. Not let alone going up to New England and getting slapped around like six little puppies. And then to go up to Green Bay when you're 3-5 and to meet this challenge with the dreaded enemy and go in there and just take the game away from them. It would have been a great thing for the team to do. They went up there and they laid down like a bunch of sick dogs.
Ed, this team,
I defy anybody in this room or on the radio to tell me it was different.
Ed, this team is soft as a grave. This team is not very tough. This team is not physically tough. And to say no and to get everybody together, like I keep saying, trust me, they'll get all the guys together. They'll put their arms around each other and go, kumbaya, sit down and say, hey, listen, you know, how's the family? What's going on here? What'd you eat last night for dinner? That makes us a team. That's not making a team. He's got to do a damn thing with these guys.
You can talk
all you want to talk about. He doesn't do anything about it.
Well, what I'm trying to tell you is what I think and what you're saying. Yeah, right. Kumbaya, I agree with you, Doug. But what I'm saying, what should happen this particular time, again, the ninth game, and as pathetic as they've been playing, and you talk about discipline?
There is no discipline.
Those morons don't even know how to spell the damn word.
There is no discipline up there.
I'm telling you, George McCaskey, if he doesn't do it tonight, now, I'm going to reiterate what I said. He better do it tomorrow morning and pull everybody in. Folks, this was the ninth game of the season. We got a lot of more games to go, and five of them are at home. Five, and if they thought they heard booing before, wait. But I'm going to tell you, George McCaskey has to come in, and it can't come from Ted Phillips, and it can't come from Emery, because you want to know what? They're part of the damn problem.
Well, here's the fact, too. George McCaskey comes in. What does he tell them? You guys are bad. You guys are undisciplined. The guys are not practicing very well.
He comes in there and he says, whatever you're doing is not sufficient. You're not winning. You're not practicing. You're not playing. We're not winners. And you better be next week. Every one of you, coaches, management, and everybody's on the clock from now on out till the end of this season.
That's my point. My point is in this game, it's called fear. Fear factor. The fact is, when somebody comes in, you all, everybody's got a job.
How are you going to put the fear factor in Cutler when he's...
Fire him!
54 million... Well, he's got...
Instead of his 22 million, and tell him to go home.
He's got...
I'm telling you.
Well, it's 54 million.
No, it's 22 guaranteed or whatever it is.
54 guaranteed.
But the fact is, when it's all said and done with, these guys are getting away with murder. They're getting away with murder. He's got a coach there. You know, this thing really always pisses me off. And I play with Mike Ditka, and so have you. Everybody's going, Mike Ditka's not too smart. You know, he doesn't have this, he doesn't have that. You know, the game plan, this and that. But when it's time
he
came to play the game,
right,
when it's time that came to play the damn game, you were out there and you were busting your ass. I don't see anybody out there busting their ass at all. There's not one guy I'd take out of that team right now. If I was starting a new team over with, there's not one guy I'd grab. Not one. And what the hell does that tell you? The fact is, there's not the fear put into them, because this game is a lot about fear. You either do the job or you go home and go sell hamburgers at McDonald's. That's exactly what it is. And that's not what they're doing. They're the one dictating what's happening up there. You can't go into a football game, like Ed said, with this urgency that this football game means so much, not only for your standings, but for credit to Green Bay Packers, and you got your ass whipped by New England real bad. Two weeks ago, and you're going to walk into that field and say, oh, yeah, boy, we had some great practices last week. You know, we sat around the cafeteria and we all shared a hamburger. Okay, give me a break.
You know what? I had, you know, a mention about with Bostic and Briggs, you know.